بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسوله وصحبه أجمعين أما بعد Today بإذن الله تعالى we go on to the third principle from the four principles the book by Shaykh Mohammad bin Abdul Wahab rahmallah So we covered the first two principles and now we're moving on to the third بسم الله So I'll go on and read والقاعدة الثالثة أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ظهر على أناس متفرقين في عباداتهم منهم من يعبد الملائكة ومنهم من يعبد الأنبياء والصالحين ومنهم من يعبد الأحجار والأشجار ومنهم من يعبد الشمس والقمر وقاتلهم رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ولم يفرق بينهم So we start with the introduction from Shaykh Muhammad bin Abdul Wahab rahmallah. So the Shaykh, he mentions that the third principle is that we know that the messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that he was among people who differed in their worship. From them who were those who worshipped the angels, and from them who those who worshipped the prophets and messengers and the righteous. And from them were those who worshipped the stones and the trees. And from them were those who worshipped the sun and the moon. And the Prophet ﷺ, he fought against all of them, the Messenger of Allah, and he didn't differentiate between them. So that is the principle here. That all of them differed in their worship and the Prophet ﷺ didn't differentiate between them and he fought against them for their opposition to Tawheed. So here, the Shaykh Saleh Al Fawzan goes on to explain and the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam بُعِثَ إِلَى أُنَاسٍ مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ مِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَعْبُدُ الْمَلَائِكَ وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَعْبُدُ الشَّمْسَ وَالْقَمَرَ وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَعْبُدُ الْأَصْنَامَ وَالْأَحْجَارَ وَالْأَشْجَارَ وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَعْبُدُ الْأَوْلِيَاءَ وَالصَّالِحِينَ So in similar the Shaykh he says that the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was sent to a people from the disbelievers the polytheists from them were those who worship the angels and those who worship the sun and the moon and from them were those who worshipped idols and those who worship stones and trees and from those who worship are righteous people and the awliya, the righteous and those who are close to Allah as they presumed. The Shaykh then said, هَذَا مِنْ قُبِ الشِّرْكِ أَنَّ أَصْحَابُهُ لَا يَجْتَمَعُونَ عَلَى شَيْءٍ وَاحِدٍ بخلاف الموحدين فإن معبودهم واحد سبحانه وتعالى أأرباب متفرقون خير أم الله الواحد القهار ما تعبدون من دونه إلا أسماء سميتموها سورة يوسف 39 And the Shaykh, he says that this is from the, you know, the ugliness and the, you know, disgusting parts of the shirk, the disgusting shirk that these people, that are ones who commit the shirk, they do not gather upon one thing, on one worshipping one deity, in opposition to the monotheist, the one who, a person of Tawheed. Because their Lord is one. They gather upon worshipping one Lord, Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, Allah the Most High. So then the Shaykh he mentions the ayah. I'm just going to get that up now. Just bear with me. He mentioned, and we read the full ayah, Surah Yusuf. Oh, two companions of the prison, are many different Lords, gods better? Or Allah, the one, the irresistible. So obviously this is the address of Yusuf alayhi salam to the two people who came to him and wanted him to interpret their dreams. And you can look further into that by going referring back to Surah Yusuf. And that was ayah number 39. So the proof is that, you know, different lords are not better than worshipping the one true Lord, Allah. And then the Shaykh says, وَمَنْ فَمَنْ فمن سلبيات الشرك وأبطاله أن أن أهله متفرقون في إبادتهم لا يجمعون ضابط، لأنهم لا يصيرون على أصل، وإنما يصيرون على أحوائهم ودعاياتهم المدلين فتكثر تفرقاتهم. So then the Sheikh, he mentions that from the negative and the harms of shirk, and it's it being upon falsehood and the invalidity of shirk, is that the people of shirk, they are split up in their worship. They do not gather upon one principle. They do not gather upon one principle because they are not treading upon the foundation or the origin, and they are merely traveling upon their desires. So they're traversing upon their desires and and their claims and propaganda, their false claims and propaganda. So they splitting and their differences increase, the separation increases. So then Allah it mentions Allah's ayah, so we'll read that, which is ضرب الله مثلا مثل الرجل فيه شركاء متشاكسون ورجل سلام لرجل هل يستويان مثلا الحمد لله بل أكثرهم لا يعلمون. هذا سورة الزمر. So just going to get سورة الزمر up here. So reading that again. ضرب الله مثلا الرجل فيه شركاء متشاكسون ورجل سلام لرجل هل يستويان مثلا الحمد لله بل أكثرهم لا يعلمون. So Allah puts forth a similitude, a slave, a man belonging to many partners, like those who worship others along with Allah, disputing with one another, and a slave, a man belonging entirely to one master, like those who worship Allah alone. Are those equal in comparison? Allah, the praise and thanks are to Allah, but all the praise and thanks are to Allah, but most of them know not. So here the Shaykh, he mentions in regards to the ayah, فالذي يعبد الله وحده مثل المملوك الذي يعبده الشخص. So this was incorrect. يستعبده الشخص. So the one who's writing this down, obviously he was taking the notes from the Sheikh Fawzan's lesson, but he was wrong in his wording here. So we'll correct that. So فالذي يعبد الله وحده مثل المملوك الذي يستعبده الشخص واحد يرتاع معه يعرف مقاصده ويعرف مطالبه ويرتاه معه لكن المشرك مثل الذي له عدة المالكين لا ما يدري من يرضي منهم كل واحد له هوى وكل واحد له طلب وكل واحد له رغبة كل واحد يريده أن يأتي عنده ولهذا قال سبحانه ضرب الله مثلا رجلا فيه شركاء متشاكسون يعني يملكه عدة أشخاص لا يدري من يرضي منهم. So we just translate that and then go further. So then the Sheikh mentions the one who worships Allah alone and is like the what is like the example in the ayah is like a slave who has one master. So he has one master, so he is content with him, and he knows his purpose and he knows what is sought from him, and he is content with it. But the polytheist, his example is that of having numerous lords, those who own him. He doesn't know who to please from them. All of those lords, they have their own desires, and all of those lords, they have their requests and demands from him, and all of those and they have their own desires, and all of them they want something from him. And this is like the speech of Allah, like this ayah. Obviously, the ayah now it makes more sense. Allah puts forth the similitude of a slave belonging to many partners, like those who worship others along with Allah. So that's a mushrik who has many owners disputing with one another, and a slave, a man belonging entirely to one master, meaning like those who worship Allah alone. If he's got one master, he knows what his Lord needs, and it's upon clarity. So then the Sheikh says he's yani, meaning that he's so the first one is that he has many owners, many lords. So he doesn't know who from them to please. Wa rajul salaman li rajulin, and then here he says, and a slave man belonging entirely to one master. Yeah. Malikuhu shakhs wahid, his lord is one. Hadha yarta'u ma'ahu, he is the one who is content with him. Hadha mithl darabahu Allahu lil mushrik wa lil muwahhid, and this is an example that Allah gave of a polytheist mushrik and the one who is a person of tawheed. Yeah, so that's the example, one who has many masters and one who has one. Yeah, and that is the example that Allah has struck in the ayah. So then the Shaykh says, فَالْمُشْرِكُونَ مُتَفَرِّقُونَ فِي إِبَادَتِهِمْ وَنَبِي صَلَى اللَّهِ وَسَلَمْ قَاتَلَهُمْ وَلَمْ يُفَرِّقْ بَيْنَهُمْ قَاتَلَ الْوَثَنِيِّينَ وَقَاتَلَ الْيُهُودَ وَالنَّصَارَى وَقَاتَلَ الْمَجُوسَ وَقَاتَلَ الْجَمِيعَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ وَقَاتَلَ الَّذِينَ يَعْبُدُونَ الْمَلَائِكَةَ وَالَّذِينَ يَعْبُدُونَ الْأَوْلِيَاءَ الصَّالِحِينَ لَمْ يُفَرِّقْ بَيْنَهُمْ. So the Shaykh says, the mushriks have split up in their worship, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he fought against them, and he did not differentiate between them. He fought against the idol worshippers, and he fought against the Jews and the Christians, and he fought against the Magians or the fire worshippers at that time, the Majus, they said. And he fought against the other types of disbelievers, all of them disbelievers. And he also fought against those who used to worship the angels, and then all those who used to worship the righteous people. And he did not differentiate between them. So فَهَذَا فِي رَدٌّ عَلَى الَّذِينَ يَقُولُونَ الَّذِي يَعْبُدُ الصَّنَمَ لَيْسَ مِثْلَ الَّذِي يَعْبُدُ رَجَلًا صَالِحًا وَمَلَكًا مِنَ الْمَلَائِكَةِ لِأَنَّ هَؤُلَاءِ يَعْبُدُونَ أَحْجَارًا وَأَشْجَارًا وَيَعْبُدُونَ جَمَادَاتٍ أما الذي يعبد رجلا صالحا ووليا من أولياء الله ليس مثل الذي يعبد الأصنام. So the Shaykh, he said, this is a refutation against those who say that those who worship idols are not like those who worship a man that is righteous or an angel from the angels. Because these who worship idols, they're worshipping stones and trees, and they're worshipping immaterial, you know, material things. So things that are what do you say, jamadat, so we say like don't have any inanimate beings. They're worshipping inanimate beings. As for those who worship righteous men, or from the friends of Allah, they are not like these who worship idols. So what they're doing now, trying to make an excuse for this worship. So and which occurs. Sadly, وَيُرِيدُونَ بِذَلِكَ أَنَّ الَّذِينَ يَعْبُدُ الْقُبُورَ قُبُورَ اللَّانَ يَخْتَلِفُ حُكْمَهُ أَنَ الَّذِي يَعْبُدُ الْأَصْنَامَ فَلَا يَكْفُرْ وَلَا يَعْتَبِرْ أَمَلَهُ هذا شرك ولا يجوز قتاله. So now this is the point why they try to make that point, and they won by way of that by the worshippers of the grave, the worshippers of grave, one by the way of that, that the different the ruling upon them differs to those who worship idols. So they're the ones who want the ruling to be made different because they worship graves. They want their ruling to be upon them to be different to those of who worship idols, so that they are not, you know, excommunicated from Islam. They're not taken out for Islam, and they are not considered that they don't, and they, that their action is not considered shirk, and that is not permissible to fight them. So that's what they intend by that. فَنَقُولُ, and we say, the Shaykh says, الرسول لم يفرق بينهم بل اعتبرهم مشركين كلهم واستحل دماءهم وأموالهم ولم يفرق بينهم والذين يعبدون المسيح والمسيح رسول الله والمسيح رسول الله ومع هذا قاتلهم واليهود يعبدون عزيرا وهو من أنبيائهم أو من صالحيهم قاتلهم رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لم يفرق بينهم فالشرك لا تفريق فيه بين من يعبد رجلا صالحا أو يعبد سنما أو حجرا أو شجرا لأن الشرك هو عبادة غير الله كائنا من كان ولهذا يقول وعبد الله ولا تشرك به شيئا. So will you stop there? Will you translate that and continue? Continue then. So we said, the Shaykh says, we say that the Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he did not differentiate between them, but rather he considered the mushriks, those who committed shirk with Allah, all of them to be mushrik, the one who worship along with Allah, anyone else. And he permitted their blood to be made lawful and their wealth, meaning them to be fought against and their wealth to be taken as war booty. Yeah, not to be considered Muslim. And he did not differentiate between them. And those who worship Masih, Isa, yeah, Isa alayhi salam, Masih, the messenger of Allah, yeah, with that, he fought them. They believe that they worship the Prophet Isa alayhi salam. The Christians, as we know, they say the Father, the Son, the Holy Ghost. They actually say that he is the Father and all three in one. And some say that he's the Son, but he's still God. You know, whatever they believe, they worship Isa alayhi salam. So the Prophet fought against them. And the Jews, they used to worship Uzair. It was either a prophet or a righteous person, as they said. And he believed he was the Son of God. Na'udhu billah. Who are min anbiya'ihim, from the prophets or from the righteous people. And the Prophet fought them. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he did not differentiate between them. So shirk, there's no differentiation in it between those who worship a righteous man, or they worship an idol, or they worship a stone or a tree, because shirk, that is worship of other than Allah, whatever that worship might be. And for this reason, Allah mentioned in ayah, and he said, worship Allah and do not commit shirk with him in anything. وَعْبُدُ اللَّهُ وَلَا تُشْرِكُ بِهِ شَيْئًا. So that's Surah An-Nisa. I'm just going to check. That's the rough meaning there. So he says, yeah, وَعْبُدُ اللَّهُ وَلَا تُشْرِكُ بِهِ شَيْئًا. Worship and join none with him in worship. So that was the ayah there. So then the Shaykh says, وَكَلِمَ شَيْئًا. And the word شَيْء, which means anything, yeah. في سياق النحي تعم كل شيء تعم كل من أشرك مع الله عز وجل من الملائكة والرسل والصالحين والأولياء والأحجار والأشجار. So the Sheikh is saying شيء means by itself something. So شيء in the context in this text, the prohibition is general, so it encompasses everything. So it encompasses everything, everyone who commits shirk with Allah Azza wa Jal, from those who commit shirk with Allah, with the angels and the prophets and the righteous ones on the friends of Allah and the stones and the trees. All of that is committing shirk. So he shows that even the ayah, if you look into it in grammatically, there's a benefit there that the scholars have derived. Then the Sheikh, he mentions, Sheikh Muhammad bin Abdul Wahab, he mentioned, وَدَلِيلُهُ قَوْلُهُ تَعَالَى وَقَاتِلُوهُمْ حَتَّى لَا تَكُونُ فِتْنَةٌ وَيَكُونَ الدِّينُ لِلَّهِ. That's Surah Baqarah. Yeah, Surah Baqarah. And that's, and it means, and fight them until there is no more fitna, disbelief and worshipping of others along with Allah, and all and every kind of worship is for Allah alone. So then the Shaykh, he goes on to explain this ayah, and Shaykh Saleh Fawzan, Hafidhullah, he says, and the speech, وَقَاتِلُهُمْ حَتَّى لَا تَكُونَ فِتْنَةً, and fight them until there is no fitna, disbelief and worship of others along with Allah, meaning this is الدليل على قتال المشركين من غير تفريق بينهم حسب معبوداتهم. So the Shaykh, he says, and the proof, it shows that fighting the disbelievers without making any differentiation between them according to who they worship. Yeah. And the speech of Allah, وَقَاتِلُوهُمْ وَهَذَا عَام لِكُلِّ مُشْرِكِينَ. And he said, and the speech where he says, fight them, this is general for all of the polytheists and disbelievers. So, لَمْ يَشْ لَمْ يَسْتَثْنِي أَحَدًا. So it does not, exclude or, exclude, yeah, it does not exclude anyone. So it encompasses all the disbelievers. ثُمَّ قَالَ حَتَّى لَا تَكُونَ فِتْنَةً, until there is no fitna. And here the fitna is being described as what? Disbelief and worshipping of others along with Allah. So the fitna a shirk. So the Shaykh here, he says the fitna here means shirk. So fight them until there is no shirk. That's what it means. Ay la yujad shirk, meaning there's no shirk. Wa hada amu, and this is general. Ay shirk. Sawa un shirk fil awliya والصالحين أو بالأحجار أو بالأشجار أو بالشمس أو بالقمر. So the shirk is generally encompasses all forms of shirk, which whether that shirk is with the righteous people or it's with the with the rocks and stones or with the trees or with the sun or the moon. Yeah. So any form of this worship other than Allah, or whether it even be graves. Yeah. If you put this in context. Then all of his shirk. وَيَكُونَ الدِّينَ لِلَّهِ. So the ayah where he said, وَيَكُونَ الدِّينَ لِلَّهِ, it mean, and all and every kind of worship is for Allah alone, tawheed. So تُكُونَ الْإِبَادَ كُلُّهَا لِلَّهِ. All types of worship will be only for Allah. لَيْسَ فِيهَا شَرِكَةٌ لِأَحَدْ كَائِنُ مَنْ كَانَ. There is no one who has a partner or share in that, whoever it may be. That worship only is for Allah. فَلَا فَرْقْ بَيْنَ الشِّرْكِ بالأولياء والصالحين أو بالأحجار أو بأشجار أو بالشياطين أو غيرهم. So then the Sheikh, he says, so there is no difference between the shirk with the righteous slaves of Allah, or with the rocks and stones, or with trees, or with devils, like people worship shayateen, iblis, or other than the jinn. Or other than them, whether it might be graves as well, yeah. Or other people who are living. So then the Sheikh, he goes on to explain. Obviously, this is, we're going to go into different proofs out here, evidences. So the Sheikh, he mentions here, وَدَلِيلُ الشَّمْسِ وَالْقَمَرِ قَوْلُهُ تَعَالَى. So he's saying the belief and the proof that this used to happen, that people used to worship the sun and the moon, and it was shirk, is the proof from the eye of Allah. وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ اللَّيْلُ وَالنَّحَارُ وَالشَّمْسُ وَالْقَمَرُ لَا تَسْجُدُوا لِلشَّمْسِ وَلَا لِلْقَمَرُ. And that's Surah Fusilat, and that's verse 37. So we go to translation. He says, and from among his signs, Allah's signs, are the night and the day and the sun and the moon. Prostrate yourself not to the sun nor to the moon, but prostrate yourself to Allah who created him, if you really worship him. Now this is also a refutation of some of the juhal from the kuffar, ignorant people. They're saying, oh, Muslims worship a moon god. No, we don't. And this is a clear proof that Allah prohibits worship whether the sun or the moon. So then the Shaykh Saleh Al Fawzan explains this, and he says, دَلَّ أَنَا هُنَاكَ مَنْ يَسْجُدْ لِلشَّمْسِ وَالْقَبْرِ وَلِهَذَا نَحَى الرَّسُولُ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ عَنِ السَّلَاءِ إِنَّ طُلُوعِ الشَّمْسِ وَإِنَّ غُرُوبِهَا. So then the Shaykh Saleh Al Fawzan explains this ayah. He's saying that this ayah shows that there were those people, and there are those people who worship and prostrate to the sun and the moon. And for this reason, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam prohibited from the salah to take place at a time of the sun rising or in the sun, or the time of sun setting. So we go on to the footnotes here. كما في حديث عبد الله بن عمر رضي الله عنهما أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال لا يتحري أحدكم فيصلي عند طلوع الشمس ولا عند غروبها. So here that one of you should know that he should not pray when the sun is rising and that when it is setting. That is the hadith. And أخرجه بخاري. So it is رقم خمسة وثمانية و خمسة وثمانون وخمسمائة. So that's 585 في المواقيت in the chapter heading of timings of prayer. لا يتحري الصلاة قبل غروب الشمس ومسلم, and it's mentioned in say Muslim as well. And that is in the title heading, in the chapter heading, times prohibited to pray salah. So yeah, that is shows that it was prohibited to pray. So anything that it makes you, like, opens a path towards shirk is prohibited. So one, the shirk, he says, saddan lidhari'a, and that is to put a stop to any way or means to shirk. لِأَنَّ هُنَاكَ مَنْ يَسْجُدْ لِلشَّمْسِ إِنْدَ طُلُوئِهَا وَيَسْجُدْ لَهَا إِنْدَ غُرُوبِهَا. Because there are those who will prostrate to the sun when it rises and prostrate to it when it sets. And you see that with the kuffar, especially in the West, in the UK, and a lot of people might be from there, is they try to do that where the winter solstice and the summer solstice, and they do worship the sun. Yeah. And they do ask, they're trying to revive worshipping the sun and worshipping devils and all sorts of filth. فَنَحَيْنَا أَنْ نُصَلِّي فِي هَذَيْنَ الْوَقْتَيْنِ وَإِنْ كَانَتْ صَلَاةٌ لِلَّهِ. So we were prohibited from praying in these two times, and even if that is prayer, is only for Allah. Then he said, لكن لما كان في الصلاة في هذا الوقت مشابهة لفعل المشركين منع من ذلك سدا للذريعة التي تفضي إلى الشرك. So then he mentions, but when the Salah around these times resembled the actions of the disbelievers, it was prohibited, Muslims prohibited from doing that as a way of, a prevention or a means that would lead to committing shirk. And the Prophet ﷺ, wa Rasul ﷺ, jaa bin nahi an shirk wa sadda zara'ihi al mufaddiya ilayhi. So the Prophet ﷺ came and with prohibiting anything that can, from shirk, and that to stop and to block any means that can lead to it. Yeah. And then he gives a book of another author who explained that in another book, in a Tawheed book. Then the Sheikh, he carries on, and then he says, Sheikh Muhammad Abdul Wahab, وَدَلِيلُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ, and the proof of the people worshiping the angels, قَوْلُهُ تَعَالَى, the speech of the Allah, the Most High, وَلَا يَأْمُرُكُمْ أَن تَتَّخِذُ الْمَلَائِكَ وَالنَّبِيِّينَ أَرْبَابًا, Surah Al-Imran, verse 80. So if you go to Surah Al-Imran, verse 80, you find this. وَلَا يَأْمَرُكُمْ أَن تَتَّخْذُوا الْمَلَائِكَ وَالنَّبِيِّينَ أَرْبَابًا أَيَأْمَرُكُمْ بِالْكُفْرِ بَعْدَ إِذَا أَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. That's the full ayah. Nor would he order you to take angels and prophets for lords, gods. Would he order you to disbelieve after you have submitted to Allah's will? So that is Surah Al-Imran. So here it shows again the angels as well as the prophets. Yeah. So then the Shaykh, he explains it. قَوْلُهُ وَدَلِيلُ مَلَائِكَ إِلَخْ. So, and the statement of Allah and the Most High, and the proof of Malaika, to the end of his speech. So the ayah, sorry, was وَلَا يَأْمَرُكُمْ أَن تَتَّخْذُ الْمَلَائِكَ وَالنَّبِيِّينَ أَرْبَابًا. But this وَدَلِيلُ مَلَائِكَ is the speech of the Shaykh Muhammad Abdul Wahab. To the end of it, it shows دل على أن هناك من أبد الملائكة والنبيين وأن ذلك شرك. It shows that there were those who used to worship the angels and the prophets, and that is shirk. Yeah. Then we go on to ودليل الأنبياء قوله تعالى, and the proof of worshiping of the prophets is a speech of Allah the Most High. وَإِذَا قَالَ اللَّهُ يَا عِيسَى ابْنُ مَرْيَمَ أَأَنْتَ قُلْتَ لِلنَّاسِ اتَّخِذُونِي وَأُمِّيَ إِلَٰهَيْنِ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ قَالَ سُبْحَانَكَ مَا يَكُونُ لِي أَنْ أَقُولَ مَا لَيْسَ لِي بِحَقٍّ إِن كُنْتُ قُلْتُهُ فَقَدْ عَلِمْتَهُ تَعْلَمُ مَا فِي نَفْسِي وَلَا أَعْلَمُ مَا فِي نَفْسِكَ إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ أَلَّامُ الْغُيُوبِ. And that's Surah Al-Ma'idah, verse 116, so the proof that angels prophets were worshipped is where Allah mentions, remember when Al-Hawariyun, yeah, the disciples of Prophet Isa alayhi salam said, O Isa, Jesus, son of Mary, can your Lord, no, this is the other one, so this one will be Surah Al-Ma'idah, and it was 116. So let me just get that now. Surah Al-Ma'idah, so I can get the exact translation rather than give you a rough. Translation, just bear with me a second. So yeah, got it there. So he said, I remember when Allah will say on the day of resurrection, so Allah will say this, O Isa, Jesus, son of Maryam, alayhi salam, did you say unto men, worship me and my mother as two gods besides Allah? He will say, glory be to you. It was not for me to say that I had no right to say. Had I said such a thing, you would have surely have known it. You know what is in my inner self, though I do not know what is in yours. Truly you, only you, are the all-knower of all that is hidden and unseen. So that was the response of Isa alayhi salam. And that is a response that a lot of the Christians should know, you know, because it doesn't make sense to worship a man, to worship his mother, you know, and to worship, you know, anyone other than Allah. Now that there's three in one, it doesn't make sense at all. But anyway, going back to this point, the Shaykh, he says, وَقُولُهُ دَلِيلَ الْأَنْبِيَاء, and the speech of the Shaykh Muhammad bin Abdul Wahab, where he says that proof that Anbiya were worship. This is a proof that the worship, the Anbiya were worship, and there was shirk committed in the worship, like that of Mithal Ibadat al-Asnam, like the way that idols are worshipped. So ففيه رد على من فرق في ذلك من عباد القبور. So this is a refutation upon those who differentiate in this, in that, from those who worship the graves. Why? They're trying to find a way out to do that. And Shaitan has made that fair seeming to them. فهذا فيه رد على هؤلاء الذين يقولون إن الشرك عبادة الأصنام ولا يسوي عندهم بين من عبد الأصنام وبين من عبد وليا أو رجل صالح, وينكرون التسوية بين هؤلاء. So the Shaykh, he says, so this is a refutation of these people, these grave worshippers, those who say only shirk occurs with the worship of idols, and that you cannot make equal them between those who worship idols and those who worship a wali, according to them, a righteous person, or you know, from a friend of Allah, and they deny this, you know, make equating these two, shirk with idols and shirk with worshiping a righteous person. وَيَزْعَمُونَ أَنَّ الشِّرْكَ مَقْصُورٌ عَلَى إِبَادَةِ الْأَصْنَامِ فَقَتْ. And they claim or they allege that shirk is only limited to worshiping the idols only. وَحَذَا مِنَ الْمُغَالَةَ الْوَادِهَا مِنْ نَاحِيَتَيْنِ. So then the Shaykh, he says this is from, you know, from one of the erroneous views from two angles. النَاحِيَةَ الْأُولَى أَنَّ اللَّهَ جَلَّ وَعَلَى فِي الْقُرْآنِ أَنْكَرَ عَلَى الْجَمِيعِ وَأَمَرَ بِقِتَالِ الْجَمِيعِ. So the first angle is, or first view is, that Allah, the Most High, He in the Quran, He denied all of this. Yeah, He denied and refuted all this, and He commanded with fighting all of them, all the ones who made shirk. ومن ناحية ثانية, and from the second angle, أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لم يفرق بين عابد الصنم وعابد الملك أو رجل صالح. And the second angle is that the Prophet ﷺ, he did not differentiate between the worshipper of the idol and the worshipper of the of a righteous, of an angel or a righteous person. So he fought against all of them. So that's what the Prophet ﷺ as well. So here there's a refutation of the argument. Firstly, from Allah in the Quran, where Allah warned against all the shirk from all types of it, and also commanded with the fighting against the mushrikeen. And from the second angle, we said that the Prophet ﷺ didn't differentiate between the one who was worshipping an idol or an angel or a righteous person. So then we're going to mention this last one, which is Dalil al-Saliheen, qawluhu ta'ala, and our proof for that the righteous people were worshipping his shirk. It's from the speech of Allah, أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ وَيَبْتَغُونَ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهِمُ الْوَصِيلَةَ أَيُّهُمْ أَقْرَبُ وَيَرْجُونَ رَحْمَتَهُ وَيَخَافُونَ عَذَابَهُ. So that is in Surah Al-Isra. So if you look at Surah Al-Isra now, try to get that out. So then we say the translation of the meaning, we'll read the full ayah. So أولئك الذين يدعون يبتغون إلى ربهم الوسيلة أيهم أقرب ويرجون رحمته ويخافون عذابه إن عذاب ربك كان محظورا. So those whom they call upon, like Isa, Jesus, son of Mary, Maryam, Uzair, Ezra, desire for themselves means of access to the Lord Allah, as to which of them should be the nearest. And they, Isa, Uzair, and Ezra, angels, and others, hope for his mercy and fear his torment. Verily, the torment of your Lord is something to be afraid of. So that is a proof of the righteous. So here the Shaykh, he says, وَدَلِيلُ الصَّالِحِينَ, the proof of the righteous that they will worship, meaning, أَنَّ هُنَاكَ مَنْ أَبَدَ الصَّالِحِينَ مِنَ الْبَشَرِ. That the world people, and there are people who worship the righteous from mankind. قَالُوا تَعَالَى أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ يَبْتَغُونَ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهِمُ الْوَصِيلَةَ أَيُّهُمْ أَقْرَبُ. So then he mentions the Shaykh mentions the ayah, those whom they call upon, like Isa, Maryam, Uzair, the angels, desire for themselves a means to access their Lord. Yeah, so they say that it's a wasila, means to access the Lord. He said, قيل نزلت هذه الآية في من يعبد المسيح وأمه وأزير. فأخبر سبحانه أن المسيح وأمه مريم وأزير كلهم عباد لله ويتقربون إلى الله ويرجون رحمته ويخافون عذابه فهم عباد محتاجون إلى الله مفتقرون إليه يدعونه ويتوسلون عليه بالطاعة يبتغون إلى ربهم الوسيلة يعني القرب منه سبحانه بطاعته وعبادته فدل على أنهم لا يصلحون للعبادة لأنهم بشر محتاجون فقراء يدعون الله ويرجون رحمته ويخافون عذابه ومن كان كذلك لا يصلح أن يعبد مع الله عز وجل. So we stop there. So then the Sheikh, he says, there are those who worship righteous, we said that. And then he said, this ayah was revealed for those who revealed in regards to those who used to worship Isa, alayhi, the Christians, and his mother, and Uzair, meaning the Jews. So Allah the Most High informed them that Masih and his Isa alayhi salam and his mother Maryam and Uzair, all of them are the servants are ubadun li Allah. Yeah, they are the servants of Allah and the worshippers of Allah, and they come close to Allah and they seek His mercy. Yeah, and they fear His punishment. So they are the worshippers that are in need of Allah, and they are, you know, in the need of Allah, and they call upon Him, and they seek a way or means to Him by being obedient to Allah. So he says, يَبْتَغُونَ إِلَى رَبِّهِمْ الْوَسِيلَ. Yeah, and we said that that means that the desire for themselves a means of access to the Lord. So as to which of them should be the nearest. Yeah. Meaning al-qurb minhu, meaning they would seek nearness to Him, the Most High, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by obedience and by worshipping. Why? By worshipping Him. So they seek clearness to closeness and nearness to Allah by being obedient to Allah and by worshipping Him. And that's what we all should do as Muslims. So فَدَلَّ عَلَىٰ أَنَّهُمْ. So that it shows that it's not right to give worship because to them, because they are humans. They are in need and they are poor and needy. They actually worship Allah and they call upon Allah and they seek His mercy and they fear His punishment. And whoever is like this, then it's not right for anyone to worship that person with Allah Azza wa Jal. So the one who is need himself, like Isa alayhi salam, is in need himself of Allah. So is Uzair and so is Maryam alayhi salam. So all of them, it's not right to worship them. Then the Shaykh, he says, وَقُلْ الثَّانِي أَنَّهَا نَزَلَتْ فِي أُنَاسٍ مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ كَانُوا يَعْبَدُونَ نَفَرًا مِنَ الْجِنِّ فَأَسْلَمَ الْجِنُّ وَلَمْ يَعْلَمْ هَؤُلَاءِ الَّذِينَ يَعْبَدُونَهُمْ بِإِسْلَامِهِمْ وَصَارُوا يَتَقَرَّبُونَ إِلَى اللَّهِ بِطَاعَةِ وَالدَّرَاءَ وَيَرْجُونَ رَحْمَتَهِ وَيَخَافُونَ عَذَابَهُ فَهُمْ عُبَّادٌ مُحْتَاجُونَ فُقَرَاءَ لَا يَسْلُهُونَ لِلْإِبَادَةِ. So then the second speech is in regard to this ayah that we mentioned, about those who they call upon Isa and Maryam and Uzair and angels, desire for themselves a means of access to the Lord, as to which of them should be nearest, and there Isa, Uzair and Ezra and angels and others hope for his mercy and fear his torment, whether the torment of your Lord is something to be afraid of. So that the second opinion is that it, so first is that it was revealed in regards to those who worship Isa, Maryam and Uzair, and the second opinion is that it was revealed in regards to people from the disbelievers, polytheists, who used to worship a party from the jinn, and the jinn actually became Muslim, and the people who used to worship them did not know that they become Muslim, and they continued. So then the angel, the jinn, they became those who became close to Allah by obeying Him, and you know, and they sought His mercy, and they used to fear His punishment. So they were the worshippers that were in need of Allah. So it's not permissible to worship these. So they themselves, alhamdulillah, worship Allah. And this happens many times. There might be a righteous person that is worshipped. He will be, if he knew that, he'll be freeing himself. Like, we give example time and time again from the subcontinent is Abdul Qadir Jilani. And they call Gawth, Nadham, Na'udhu Billah, all these names. But he was from Iraq. He was a Sunni, Athari. Yeah? He was upon Hanbali fiqh, and mashallah, he was a righteous person. But the people after him, they worshipped him, and he would deny their worship. Same way with the people, some people going to extremes with Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and they worship him. And Allah's Messenger will deny that. Same way with Isa and any other righteous people, from the prophets and messengers and from the righteous people. So, أيّ كان المراد بالآية الكريمة فإنها تدل على أن على أنه لا يجوز عبادة الصالحين سواء كانوا من الأنبياء والصديقين أو من الأولياء والصالحين فلا تجوز عبادتهم لأن الكل عباد كل عباد نعم كل عباد للفقراء إليه كل عباد لله فقراء إليه فكيف يعبدون مع الله جل وعلا. So the Shaykh says, whatever the intent of the whoever the intended people for the revelation of the ayah may be, of this noble ayah, this ayah does show and indicate that it is not permissible to worship the righteous, regardless of whether that person they be from the prophets or they be from those truthful worshippers or those from the friends of Allah or the righteous people. It's not permissible to worship them because all of them are worshippers of Allah. They are in need of Him. And so how can they be worship with Allah, the Most High? وَالْوَسِيلَ مَعْنَهَا الطَّاعَ وَالْقُرْبِ. So a wasila, and the means, here the meaning is by obedience and nearness. So for here, and in the Arabic language, الشيء الذي يوصل إلى المقصود. It means that something by way of which you reach the intended goal. فالذي يوصل إلى رضا الله وجنته هو الوسيلة إلى الله. هذه هي الوسيلة المشروعة في قول تعالى وابتغوا إليه الوسيلة. So then the Sheikh, he says, so this means of getting closer to Allah, you know. So فَالَّذِي يُوَسِّلُ, so that which, you know, makes you arrive to the pleasure of Allah and to the His Jannah, the paradise. This is a means to Allah, and this is a wasila that is legislated in the speech of Allah, and seek to Him a wasila. Surah Al-Ma'idah. So when you see Surah Al-Ma'idah, that was verse, all you who believe, do your duty to Allah and fear Him, seek the means of approach to Him, and strive hard in His cause as much as you can, so that you may be successful. So here, seek the means of approach to Him. So that's what it means. Yeah. So, أما المحرفون والمخرفون فيقولون الوسيلة أن تجعل بينك وبين الله واسطة من الأولياء والصالحين والأموات تجعلهم واسطة بينك وبين الله ليقربوك إلى الله ما تعبدهم إلا ليقربونا إلى الله زلفا. So then the people who distort, so the people who distort, and so the people who distort the ayahs of Allah, they say, so they say, let me see if I got that, and that is Surah Az-Zumar. So he will give the full ayah, Surah Az-Zumar. Yeah. Yeah, so we give the full ayah. لِلَّهِ الدِّينُ الْخَالِصُ وَالَّذِينَ اتَّخَذُوا مِنْ دُونِهِ أَوْلِيَاءَ مَا تَعْبُدُهُمْ إِلَّا لِيُقَرِّبُونَ إِلَى اللَّهِ زُلْفَى إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَحْكُمُ بَيْنَهُمْ فِي مَا هُمْ فِيهِ يَخْتَلِفُونَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَحْدِي مَنْ هُوَ كَاذِبٌ كَفَّارًا. So Allah mentions, surely the religion and the worship and obedience is for Allah only, and those who take awliya, protectors, helpers, lords and gods besides Him, say, we worship them only that they may bring us near to Allah. Worry Allah will judge between them and concerning that wherein they differ, truly Allah guides not him who is a liar and a disbeliever. So this shows a proof that these people would say, they would use this ayah. So the Shaykh, he says that they would, these people who are, you know, who change the meaning, they make between you and between Allah an intermediary. From there, from this ayah, that is their protectors, awliya, and from the righteous, and from the dead. Yeah, and they make them an intermediary between you and Allah so that you can get closer to Allah. And they say, we do not worship them except that they become they make us closer to Allah. Yeah, or they we do not worship, and those who take, we worship them only that they may bring us near to Allah. That's what they say. So, فَمَعْنَى الْوَسِيلَ عِنْدَ الْهَؤُلَاءِ الْمُخَرِّفِينَ أن تجعل بينك وبين الله واسطة تعرف الله بك وتنقل له حاجتك وتخبره عنك كأن الله جل وعلا لا يعلم أو كأن الله جل وعلا بخيل لا يعطي إلا بعدما يلحي إليه بالوسائط تعالى الله عما يقولون ولهذا يشبهون يشبهون على الناس ويقولون الله جل وعلا يقول أولئك الذين يدعون يبتغون إلى ربهم الوسيلة فدل على أن اتخاذ الوسائط من الخلق إلى الله أمر مشروع لأن الله أثنى على أهله وفي الآية الأخرى يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وابتغوا إليه الوسيلة وجاهدوا في سبيله. So we're just going to go over that, what the Sheikh says. So he says the meaning of wasila with these people who, you know, they twist the meaning of the words, is that to make between you and between Allah an intermediary so that Allah can know you. Yeah, and that you can transmit to Allah, the intermediary can transmit the your needs to Allah and inform Allah about you. As if Allah, Most High, doesn't know. As if Allah is, you know, stingy. That He will not give you, na'udhu billah, except if you go through this way of seeking an intermediary. Allah is more free from what they say and describe Allah with. And for this reason, they have likened Allah. يُشَبِّهُونَ عَلَى الناس ويقولون, and they basically say that Allah the Most High says, أولئك الذين يدعون يبتغون إلى ربهم وسيلة. So they try to change the meaning of this ayah. Yeah. So they try to change the meaning of this ayah. So as we mentioned before, أولئك الذين يبتغون, they've changed it. Uh, So yeah, so أولئك الذين يدعون يبتغون إلى ربهم وسيلة. So they say that those who worship, they see, they seek for them for the in the Lord a means to get closer to the Lord. So this shows that that is taking intermediary from the creation of between that person and Allah is something that is legislated. لِأَنَّ Allah, because Allah praised these people. So if you actually go into this ayah, if we bring it up, we'll go through the meaning and we'll show how wrong they are. So we go bring this ayah up again, and that was أُولَٰئِكَ. Let me bring that. Okay. Bear with me a second. So that's أُولَٰئِكَ. أولئك الذين أولئك الذين يدعون So yeah, Surah Al-Isra. So those whom they call upon, you mentioned the ayah before, Jesus, Mary, is their desire for themselves a means of access to their Lord. So as to which of them should be the nearest. Yeah? So they use this ayah in a wrong way, as you can see. Yeah. So they try to twist the meaning. So then the Shaykh says, and then we, in another ayah, يَا أَيُّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهِ وَابْتَغُوا إِلَيْهِ وَصِيلًا وَجَاهِدُوا فِي سَبِيلِهِ. And that's Surah Al-Ma'idah 35. So if we go to the Surah Al-Ma'idah 35 that we did. O you who believe, do your duty to Allah and fear Him. Seek the means of approach to Him and strive hard in His cause as much as you can so that you may be successful. So you see again, they try to twist that to mean someone intermediary when it doesn't mean that. قالوا إن الله أمرنا أن نتخذ وسيلة إليه. They say Allah has commanded us that we should take an intermediary with Him. ووسيلة معناها الوسائط. So they change the meaning of وسيلة, where it means to seek the means of approach to Him, which is obedience, yeah, and worshiping Allah. They change it to what? They change it to an intermediary. So so in Allah, so they say that ووسيلة معنا الوسائط, meaning the intermediary. هكذا يحرفون الكلمة الكلم عن موادئه. So this is how they twist the meaning of a word from its correct meaning. فالوسيلة المشروعة في القرآن وفي السنة هي الطاعة التي تقرب إلى الله تقرب إلى الله والتوصل إليه بأسماء وصفاته سبحانه وتعالى. هذه وسيلة المشروعة. أما توصل بالمخلوقين إلى الله فهو وسيلة ممنوعة ووسيلة شركية وهي التي اتخذ المشركون من قبل. We'll go to the ayah. Just translate this. So then the Sheikh, he says, then he says the وسيلة that is legislated in the Quran and in the Sunnah is what? Obedience, that which brings you closer to Allah. And التوصل to seek a means to call to Allah when you're making a supplication is by way of His names. So you, for example, and His attributes, the Most High. So you say, for example, Allah, you are Razak, give me risk. You are Allah, you are Shafi, the one who cures, give me Shifa. Yeah? So it's like this, yeah? So you call, Ya Allah, Al-Alim, give me more knowledge. You are the All-Knowing, give me more knowledge. Ya Al-Qawi, the All-Strong, give me strength. You know, like this. So hadi hiya al-wasiyah. This is the right way of legislate, of using Allah's names and attributes to call upon Allah and for what you need. As for, you know, using a tawassul, call, you know, using the created beings to seek an intercession with Allah, then this is what this is a forbidden form of wasila. and wasila shirkiya, the wasila of shirk, a means of shirk, and it is what the mushriks took as a way from before. And the ayah Allah mentions, and it mentioned, وَيَعْبَدُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ مَا لَا يَضُرُّهُمْ وَلَا يَنْفَعُهُمْ وَيَقُولُونَ هَؤُلَاءِ شُفَعَاؤُنَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. So they and they worship other than Allah that which do not harm them and do not benefit them. And they say, these are our intercessors with Allah. Surah Yunus, verse 18. And Allah also mentions, وَالَّذِينَ اتَّخَذُوا مِن دُونِهِ أَوْلِيَاءَ مَا تَعْبُدُهُمْ إِلَّا لِيُقَرِّبُونَ إِلَى اللَّهِ زُلْفَى. And Allah mentions in Surah Zumar again, verse 3, and those who took took other than Allah as وَالَّذِينَ اتَّخَذُوا مِن دُونِهِ, and they took other, let's just get that one, to other than Allah as protectors, they said, we do not worship them except to be bring us closer to Allah. So that's what he says, Surah Zumar, verse 3. So هذا هو الشرك الأولين والآخرين سواء بسواء وإن سموا وسيلة فهو شرك بعينه وليس هو وسيلة التي شرعها الله سبحانه وتعالى لأن الله لم يجعل الشرك وسيلة عليه أبدا وإنما الشرك مبعد عن الله سبحانه وتعالى إنه من يشرك بالله فقد حرم الله عليه الجنة ومأواه النار وما للظالمين من أنصار فكيف يجعل الشرك وسيلة إلى الله تعالى أما يقولون. So then the Shaykh mentions the shirk of the people of the first and of those on the last one, those in present time and those in the past, is equal. Yeah, even if they call it wasila, a means to get closer to Allah, it is shirk. Yeah, in its meaning and its reality, and it is not a wasila, a means to Allah, yeah, that is legislated by Allah and the Most High, because Allah will not make shirk a mere or means to Him ever. Yeah, and shirk is something that distances a person from Allah, the Most High. Allah mentions, so is in Surah Al-Ma'idah. Let's just check that. Surah Ma'idah. It's this one. Say, إِنَّهُ مَنْ يُشِكْ. So he said, verily, whoever sets up a partner in worship with Allah, then Allah has forbidden paradise to him, and the fire will be his adob. And for the zalimun, the polytheists and wrongdoers, there are no helpers. So the Allah mentions the fact. So how can Allah make hook? So how can Allah make shirk a way of means to Allah, or anyone make shirk a way of means to Allah Ta'ala? Allah is more way above what they describe Allah with. So then the Shaykh is going to finish and we'll stop here. الشاهد من الآية أن فيها دليل على أن هناك من من على أن هناك من المشركين من يعبد الصالحين لأن الله بين ذلك وبين أن هؤلاء الذين تعبدونهم هم عباد فقراء عباد فقراء يبتغون إلى ربهم وسيلة يعني يتقربون إليه بالطاعة أن أيهم أقرب يتسابقون إلى الله جل وعلا بالعبادة لفقرهم إلى الله وحاجتهم ويرجون رحمته ويخافون عذابه ومن كان كذلك فإنه لا يصلح أن يكون إلها يدعى ويعبد مع الله عز وجل. So this point here, the Shaykh saying from the ayah, is that there is a proof from the ayah that there are those who are from the mushriks, polytheists, who worship the righteous, because Allah clarified that in the ayah, and He clarified that these people, the ones that they worship, they are servants and they are in need of Allah. They seek to their means towards the Lord, meaning that they would seek to be close to Allah by obedience. أيهم أقرب. They want to know who is closer to Allah. So they what they compete with one another to get closer to Allah, the Most High. We worship because of the need of Allah, and they seek His mercy, and they fear His punishment. And whoever is like that, then he is not correct for that person to be taken as a Lord or to be called upon and worshipped with Allah Azza wa Jal. So we stop there, inshallah. We'll continue from here next lesson. Lesson بإذن الله تعالى. جزاك الله خير. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك. أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت. أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.